Well, good morning from New York City. I'm Anne Marie Green.
And I'm Jamie Yuccas, filling in for Vladimir Duthie this morning. Here's a look at the top stories happening right now. We're getting a fresh look at how the job market is doing. We're going to break down this morning's new report that we just got in, what it tells us about the economy.
The cleanup from Idalia is underway in the southeast, so we're going to have a look at the aftermath and why the governor says they received fewer 911 calls this time around.
And the search is on for a convicted killer who escaped from a prison in Pennsylvania. The warning from one prosecutor who's saying he has nothing to lose.
Plus, a mother who lost her son in the Sandy Hook school shooting is turning her pain into action. How her nonprofit is working to make schools safer.
And if you're hitting the skies today, pack your patience a little bit. You won't be alone. Anne Marie and I are going to talk to a travel reporter about what you need to know before you head out the door on this Labor Day weekend.
I'm hitting the road, and I'm already frustrated.
Are
so
you
it's
stressed?
Too late. Yeah, I'm stressed just thinking about it.
Well, we are going to begin this hour with the latest labor market data, but that doesn't ever stress us out, does it? As the U.S. continues to add jobs, though, at a robust pace, it is good news. 187,000 new jobs were created in the month of August, and that was higher than expected. The unemployment rate rose to 3.8%. President Biden is expected to deliver remarks later this morning on those numbers.
So joining me now here in Studio 57 for more on this is Barron's senior writer Al Root. Thanks for joining us. We were talking a little bit ahead of time. You heard Jamie say this is good news, mm-hmm. that we've created 187,000 new jobs. Is it good news? What does it mean?